Why, hello there again, Racked Kindergartners. This is Miss Phelps, for those of you who don't know me, but by now you probably know me. And I am super excited for our lesson today because we are going to be learning about two other kinds of community helpers. But both of these community helpers usually work together in order to help people in our community. The first type of community helper that we are going to learn about are doctors. Now, what doctors do is they help sick people and they help to make sure that people who are healthy stay healthy. And we're going to talk a little bit more about what doctors do as we read a book about them. And then the second thing that nurses do, or the second kind of community helper we're going to learn about, are nurses. And we're going to learn about all the wonderful things that nurses do in order to help keep us healthy. So, and we will be reading a short book about them as well. I'm going to share my screen with you. And as you can see, we are learning about community helpers, doctors today. Make my face a little bit bigger. There we go. Doctor's visit. It is time for Emma's visit to the doctor. He checks inside her ears. Then he listens to Emma's heart and lungs. Emma is healthy, and he does that with this thing right here. This is called a stethoscope, and it is what doctors and nurses use to listen to your heart and your lungs and sometimes other things too to make sure everything is nice and healthy. What are doctors? Doctors give medical care. They know how to treat illnesses, which is when you're sick with something like the flu or you have a stuffy nose, and injuries. And injuries are things where you hurt yourself, like maybe you fall off your bike and you scrape your knee. You have an injury, not necessarily an illness. People visit doctors in offices. So if you go to your pediatrician, they're most likely in an office. In clinic. They can see doctors in hospitals at any time. So there are also doctors that work in hospitals. Rochester has a lot of hospitals and we have a lot of really good hospitals. What do doctors do? Doctors check patient health. A patient is somebody who goes to see a doctor. So in this picture, this guy right here is the doctor. And this girl that it looks like he's checking maybe her tonsils, she is the patient. She is the one that the doctor is just checking up on or helping. Doctors check patient health. They suggest practices to keep them healthy. Doctors plan how to care for patients. They order medicine for them. Some doctors have special jobs. They can operate on people or deliver babies. And that's only a few of the things that doctors can do. They can do lots of different stuff depending on what they specialize in. What makes a good doctor? Doctors make careful decisions. Patient lives are in their hands. And over here it says doctor skills, caring, good communicators, that means that they're good at working with other people and talking to them and talking to their patients. Careful. And they are good listeners. That's very important too, right? Doctors are also friendly. Sicknesses can be scary and painful. Doctors make them better. And that is the end of this book. And so here are just a few words that we're going to go over so you can, just so you can get a better idea about them. So clinics, places where people get checkups or other short medical visits. So a clinic is not going to be a doctor. It's usually, or it's not going to be a hospital. You usually just go there. You see the doctors and nurses for a short visit, like a checkup, or sometimes if you're sick, you can go to a clinic. Or if your mom or another woman you know is pregnant, sometimes they will go to a clinic as well. Medicine. You guys know what medicine is, right? So medicine are drugs used to treat sicknesses. And sometimes there's different kinds of sicknesses, right? Hospitals, places where people receive emergency care or much longer medical visits. There's a lot of things that you can do in a hospital, not just emergency care, but that is a big part of what they do. Operates, perform medical care through surgery. Injuries, we talked about injuries already. That's when you get a boo-boo somewhere and you break your arm, you scrape your knee, you bump your head, you have an injury, right? An illness is like you're coughing or throwing up or running nose, you have an illness. And patient, we already went over what a patient is too. A patient is the person that the doctor is either checking up on or helping. And now we're going to learn about nurses as well, because doctors and nurses often work together. Although sometimes doctors can work by themselves and sometimes nurses can work by themselves too, depending on what they're doing. Nurses work in hospitals and also in doctor's offices and clinics and anywhere that a doctor would work. They help patients. Patients are sick or hurt people. Nurses also work in schools. They take care of sick students. Where else do you think that nurses can work? Pause this video, think about that question. Where else do you think nurses could work? Nurses use special tools. The scale, that's this guy right here, checks weight, and a thermometer checks your temperature. Nurses go to school for many years. They need to go to school for at least 4 years, although many of them go for longer. Then they are ready to help patients. So if you want to be a nurse or a doctor, you need to go to college. And if you want to be a doctor, then after college, you need to go to medical school. Nurses have many tools. So they have the stethoscope, just like doctors, to treat heartbeat. Did we skip a page? They often wear scrubs just like doctors, although doctors will sometimes wear a white coat on top of it. And then here is a thermometer. This one looks like the one that our nurse uses at school. So now that we have read a book about doctors and we've read a book about nurses, now it's your turn to apply what you have learned. And we're going to do this in one of my favorite ways. You are going to pretend to be a doctor or a nurse. So here's what you are going to do. You are going to dress up if you have dress up stuff. If you don't have dress up stuff, just pretend. You are going to be either a nurse or a doctor, and you can pick whichever one you want. Then you're going to need to find a patient. Maybe you could pick one of your brothers or sisters, or you could pick your mom or your dad or whoever you have around you. Then you are going to, if you're being a doctor or a nurse, you need to check their temperature to make sure they are healthy. You need to check their heart to make sure that they are healthy. Then you need to ask them how they're feeling. And if they're feeling sick or if they have an illness or an injury, you need to help them feel better. So please send a video of you playing doctor or nurse by checking someone's temperature, checking their heart, and their doctors do a lot more than this too, but three, ask them if they are healthy. And then four, if they are not healthy, if they have an illness or an injury, help them to get better. It has been so much fun learning with you all today about doctors and nurses. They are super duper important community helpers that help to keep our community healthy, and we could not do all the things that we do without them. They are working super duper extra hard right now. So if you have any doctors or nurses or med techs or pharmacists or anyone else in your family that is helping people who are sick, be sure to give them a big, 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 big thank you and tell them how important they are to you and how much they are helping our community. And I will see you all in the next lesson. Bye.